Masters of Wisdom Speak on the Seven Rays, The Bridge to Freedom Journal, December 1952. Lord Maha Chohan. The process of evolution, unfoldment, and development of the God design of the universe is very beautiful and might be likened unto the successive presentations in a glorious opera. Each act allowing the talents and natural heritage of a certain number of life streams full freedom to enrich the universe by the fullest outpouring of their creative endeavors. The rhythm of creation is fulfilled through self-conscious, intelligent beings who embody the keynote of each age. The life streams that these God directors gather around them amplify this keynote, and the cycle is completed through the beings who are privileged to be evolving within that age. We have passed through 6 cycles and are now entering the final act of a major cycle of 14,000 years. The curtain rings up on the activities of the 7th ray, which under the direction of the Master Saint Germain will unify the consciousness of the angelic host, the mankind of earth, and the elemental kingdoms. This era, therefore, will manifest the apex of spiritual glory through all 3 kingdoms as well as the planet itself. Ascended Master El Moira, the 1st ray, divine will and rulership. Many ages have passed into the unseen records which form the past since the 1st ray was privileged to be the predominant activity playing upon the earth, stimulating the evolution of the 3 kingdoms ascending the ladder toward perfection, side by side. In this long-forgotten era, the cosmic wheel had just begun to turn, and the powerful blue ray was the major influence of the spiritual forces which nourished the God nature in man, angel, and elemental. A goodly number from each kingdom responded to the outpouring of the 1st ray and gained their eternal freedom while it was nourishing and energizing those centers within the evolving intelligences which would best enable them to ascend consciously through cooperation with this potent power. When the cosmic wheel turned to allow the radiation of the 2nd ray to play upon our planet, we gathered all the perfection, all the consciousness, and the developed harvest of the 1st ray into the inner spheres where it remains to this day, awaiting the final act of Earth's drama when it shall be added to the heritage of the 7th ray as part of the glory of the permanent golden age which shall know no end. Ascended Master Kathumi, the 2nd ray, wisdom, guardian of youth. The 2nd great ray, which struck the earth when the cosmic wheel turned in obedience to the cosmic law's command, played like a great searchlight upon the planet and became the invisible but palpable substance of the atmosphere in which the angelic, human, and elemental kingdoms had their being. These evolutionary beings absorbed this God-directed nourishment, which enabled them to grow and mature according to the divine plan. Again, only a portion of each kingdom responded, and these joined the free beings who had availed themselves of the outpouring of the 1st ray. At the expiration of the reign of the 2nd ray, much beauty, wisdom, perfection, and momentum of God power were added to the store of Akasha to be released again in the age of the 7th ray as the gift of the 2nd ray in Earth's final hour. We, the brothers of the 2nd ray, delight in anticipating our cooperation with the activities of the ceremonial ray, which will come to such great perfection in the near future. Ascended Master Venetian, the 3rd ray, tact, tolerance, a gentle man. Even as the physical sun releases certain properties which excite the growth and development of particular flowers in successive seasons, and the vibrations within the pattern of those flowers respond only to that stimulus, so do the successive outpourings of the 7 rays from the cosmic wheel consecutively develop a group of angelic, human, and elemental beings who flower and attain God maturity in the age which is their natural time for blossoming. Others, who are marked for a later unfoldment, seem to be untouched by the very vital forces which energize and attune the inner selves of the children who are a natural part of the particular ray which is active in a cycle of time. Teachers and leaders who are inspired by the stimulation of the ray active during the time of their incarnation usually find response only from those life streams who are naturally destined to unfold in such a cycle, while the others remain among the indifferent masses until their hour comes. Just as the bulb of a flower is dormant until the season for its development calls it forth to active expression. It is only unascended beings who are impatient because all men do not respond to the same vibrations, which is as foolish an attitude as that of a gardener or a farmer who would insist that all his crops mature on the same day, in the same month, in the same season. Ascended Master Serapis Bey, the fourth ray, art and beauty, hierarch of Luxor. The turning of the cosmic wheel takes place in rhythmic cycles of approximately 2,000 years each. Thus, one complete revolution embodies a major cycle of 14,000 years. The planet Earth and the angelic, human, and elemental kingdoms evolving upon it are the recipients of the outpouring of a specific and powerfully concentrated force during each 2,000-year cycle. And all the development through the three kingdoms which contribute to the expansion of the kingdom of God becomes the heritage of the race, being held in the inner spheres by the Chohan of each ray until the complete revolution of the cosmic wheel allows the seventh ray the opportunity to draw forth and present the combined harvest of the entire 14,000-year cycle. We are at this point today. And as the seventh ray is just at the beginning of its reign, the fully gathered momentum that has been attained by all beings, powers, and legions of light through the past 12,000 years will be drawn upon the stage of life through the combined endeavors of the perfected beings who have climbed the ladder of evolution while any one of the preceding rays was active. In this era, we enjoy a triple activity. We have the natural outpouring of the seventh ray itself. We are the fortunate recipients of the gifts of the foregoing six rays, and we take part in the closing of the major cycle of 14,000 years, when the first and seventh rays meet, Alpha and Omega. Thus the immortal words, "It is finished," spoken by the Master Jesus in his role of Cosmic Christ, will be the stamp of eternal confirmation on the planet Earth's victorious evolution. Ascended Master Hilarion, the fifth ray, science and God. Up to the present time, the evolution of the angelic host, mankind, and the elemental kingdoms have proceeded without much actual cooperation among the intelligences involved. The work of the seventh ray is the drawing together and bringing to fruition the complete harvest comprising the endeavors of these kingdoms through the 14,000-year cycle. It is also the service of this ray to bring into harmonious, cooperative, and conscious unity the members of these three kingdoms. This unison of the three kingdoms is best accomplished through the beautiful rituals which embody music, rhythm, color, perfume, artistic beauty of form, including the exquisite vestments that stimulate the highest type of worship that has yet been evolved or made manifest in this chain. The great prince, Saint Germain, as lord of the ceremonial ray, will gradually draw those who are naturally attuned to his ray into conscious cooperation with the work of the new era, and he will be assisted by those volunteers from the other six rays who are most highly developed along their particular evolutionary line. This activity of the future so far transcends anything that the human mind has yet conceived. It is impossible to describe the glorious achievement that awaits the evolving life streams who will attain their freedom in this final era. Ascended Master Jesus, the sixth ray, religious worship through devotion. The turning of the cosmic wheel is governed by the God intelligence at the very center of our universe. It is a manifestation of the love of the Father, which allows each life intelligence the opportunity to be bathed in the spiritual nourishment that corresponds to his own keynote. To deny the progressive evolution of the race is as foolish as it would be for a man to refuse to believe that the crisp currents of April are followed by the soft, mellow outpouring of May, whose warm and gentle spirit allows the more delicate blooms of spring an opportunity to flourish. The currents that play upon the earth in each 2,000-year cycle are just like the diversified currents of the progressive seasons of the year, and the various intelligences of the three kingdoms are ordained by God to bloom and flower in a particular spiritual season, lest all the glory adorn one cycle, and the balance of time be barren of any manifest perfection in angel, man, or elemental. Ascended Master Saint Germain, the seventh ray, ceremonial worship, the direction of spiritual energies of both angels and men. The seventh ray is to the evolving angelic host, mankind, and the elemental kingdoms, as the season of harvest is to the agricultural kingdom. Man accepts without question the orderly procession of the natural seasons, the specific atmosphere and radiation of spring, summer, and autumn, together with the particular gifts of harvest that each season brings. But he refuses to allow the glorious spiritual seasons the same freedom to bring their gifts and powers into the experience life of the race. It is as futile to attempt to hold back the glorious perfection that will be expressed during the reign of the seventh ray as it would be for any man to refuse to allow nature to provide the harvest of the fields. Oh, how we long for the day when man will stop battling the good that God outpours through those of us who are his messengers, and working with the current of the hour, accept the fullness of its upward sweeping energies, on whose crest he may ride to immortal freedom. In my entire association with the angelic and elemental kingdoms, I have never heard a builder of the form of the early crocus refuse to allow the beauty of expression of the autumn aster, nor an angel of music refuse to accept the possibility of equal expression to an angel of healing. Man alone insists that all of his kind must fit into one pattern in order to appease his human notion of respectability. Nevertheless, I thank God that we are not all of one pattern, human thought notwithstanding.
Let there be light on earth in my body and the bodies of those who live today. Let there be light on earth in my body and the bodies of those who live today. Let there be light so we can discover that we all are lovers in a family way. Let there be light on earth in my body and the bodies of those